It's April, and we are going to finish this page today. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. This page is going to be done. I think it's oddly appropriate that this is the 20 of 20 live streams that I have done for this picture, seeing as it's 2020. It's only taken me a year to get here, but that's okay. I'm really excited to see what this looks like when it's done. So basically, all I have left to do right now is yes, Nissa, you can join us. The only thing I have left to do here is to trace the outlines along all of the castle. So I've got a good chunk of it done, but I'm just gonna fly through doing the rest of it. And I'm gonna be smart about it this time. And I'm going to start at that end of the picture and then work this direction. Shake the pasta. And then I'm ready. Thought I locked the focus. Hold on. I don't want it to keep trying to focus. Okay. Should be locked now. Let's see if I can do this and still see what I'm doing. Hopefully this dragon will stand out a little bit more now that we're at the point where we're tracing out these crystals. Thank you, Kiki. I'm trying not to stick my head in frame. Good morning, Robin. I'm glad you can stop in real quick. Thank you. Hoping to get these all traced out in, say, 2 hours. You guys think that's possible? You guys are so great. I'm glad you have faith in me. Like, I think I know why I started where I did. Because it's a little awkward tracing these. When they're up there, and I don't want to put my head in frame. But we got this. Yeah, something like that. I'm gonna scoot it over just a little bit. I think that'll help me reach where I want to reach. is one of those things that takes so much concentration out of you. No, it doesn't have to be perfect, but I think I am starting to hit my groove. Because I found this sweet spot yesterday where I was concentrating but not concentrating, if that makes sense. So how is everybody's weekend going? What are you coloring? What are you reading? What readathon are you doing, Robin? Didn't realize there was a readathon going on right now. Granted, there's always a readathon going on, so I suppose I shouldn't be overly surprised. Oh, and I was also going to tell you, Robin, that Brock has his long video up now for his spreadsheet. If you haven't caught that yet. He goes into a little bit more depth for each of those sections that he set up. I made my husband watch it yesterday. Oopsie. Clogged up. Hold on. Oh, 24 before Monday. Oh, okay, so you're trying to read 24 before Monday comes around? Hi, Grace. Nice, Kiki. Okay, keep. The rollerball keeps gumming up on my Posca. What I should do is order a couple more in this size, since this is the size I always use. I find that I don't use the bigger Poscas. There's something about this 0.7 that I really, really like. Okay, so you're reading for 24 hours. I'm like, I don't know if you can read 24 books in a weekend, but I suppose you could. Oh, you're talking about diamond painting, Grace? I know that's a big thing anymore. Though I don't think it's something I'm ever gonna get it into myself. So that people can do some very pretty things with those. Down there. Oh, I'm glad, Grace. 19 hours is still impressive, Robin. Because I know you can read a lot in 19 hours. Not sure how many hours I've read this week so far. I know I really haven't read anything this weekend. We're putting Christmas decorations away finally. Just have the Christmas trees left up that we have to pull down and put into boxes. It's my least favorite part because you have to figure out how to squish the trees. Okay, so this has been 20 streams so far. So about somewhere between like 43 and 45 hours. Something like that. It's been a project. But we can definitely see the end. I did see that he's got a new one coming out. I couldn't remember when it came out or when it's coming out. It's on my list of things to pick up when it does come out. Don't know why I just did that piece right there, but I did. It's all good. I have to do all of them anyways. I don't really do anything with my pictures when I'm done. I usually just kind of leave it in my coloring book. If I'm honest, because for the most part, it's pretty safe in there. And a lot of the things that I use aren't really color fast. So, like the markers, the Copics that I used on this, if left out in the sun, will start to fade. And I don't know if I think it's more of the journey that I like to do with these kind of pictures. Yeah, I've done about 45 hours on just this one picture. I started this last year at the end of January, and it's taken me a whole year because I've just been on and off working on it. hence why it's kind of exciting to see that we're almost there. Okay, well, I totally lost track of that, so I need to go and check that out. Because I've seen some of the stuff he was doing for it on his Instagram. Because, guys, I'm a little bit obsessed with his work, as you can tell by this phone cover. Good grief. Come on. There we go. Probably get a piece of paper out so when this starts gumming up, I can just scribble on it. You are not running out of ink. That would just throw a wrench into everything I'm trying to do right now. I'm glad you could stop by, Robin. Hope the rest of your day is amazing. So I'll set on finishing this page, and if this Posca decides to ruin that, I'm gonna be grumpy. Might have another white pen that I could use. That'll work. I can understand that, Kiki. Especially if it's artwork that I like. I tend to stalk the artist, and I'm like, I need everything you put out. Even if there's some duds in their portfolio. I'm that with that way with the authors that I buy as well. For the most part, I usually like an author's full body of work, but every once in a while there are some duds. But I'm like, I can't not, because then I don't have their whole backlist. And maybe that'll change. Almost connecting to the pieces I've already done. So I have a love-hate relationship with Geomorphia. I love this coloring book because it is the first single-sided Kirby book. And the way I color, I love the fact that I don't have to worry about ruining whatever's on the other side. What I don't like is how it feels. Like a lot of these pictures were cropped and forced into this format. Think we just had a big chunk of ice fall off the roof or the pipes. That was kind of dramatic. It's really warm out today, so all of the ice that we've had for the last week is starting to finally disappear. I think I am going to soak the tip of this Posca real quick in some warm water so I think maybe it's just gumming up on me. I don't like it. So give me 2 seconds and I will be right. Okay, I'm back. And focusing is going to become an issue. Okay. Can you focus? Okay, I'm going to lock it right there. Okay. I think that helped. Got to get all the water off my hands first. Don't want to smear what I've been doing. Sort of helped. Feel like it's really translucent. Of course, it wants to see if it can cause one last hiccup. Since we're so close. There we go. That's what I wanted. Okay, I might go over some of these spots again where the pen just started to throw a hissy fit. There's some of these lines that just got a little too pale for me. Maybe that's okay that there's some variant. Oh yeah, this is gonna go really quick now that this is actually flowing. Hi, welcome. deciding how to do some of these lines. Because they sort of complete, but they sort of don't. Especially on these bigger crystals. But they're also the crystals I think I had the most fun on. Make sure I'm not putting my hands in any of the wet Posca. Because it is something I would do. I get lost doing this. I'm almost afraid to breathe. I mess up some of the line work. Look it, we made it all the way to the corner. Stretch every once in a while. kind of fun to just lose yourself into a project. I think that's why I enjoy DIY projects and crafting projects and this kind of work so much. There might not be an end goal in mind or a purpose. But I love hyper-focusing on something. And that might be my type A personality, which can sometimes be dangerous. But it just like having a project to focus on. I don't know about you guys. Easy to fall down a rabbit hole of which crystal, which direction, how far over should I go? Not necessarily a right or wrong way. It's just one of those things that I'm like, I'm trying to do it in a way where I don't end up leaning my hand on something that I just covered. It's my only goal. And not to forget outlining something. Need to remember to breathe. And I'm looking up every once in a while. Just so I can sort of see how the whole picture is coming together. Oops. Suppose at some point I should start at the top of the castle again and then work my way down. Maybe once I get to about the halfway point, so once I finish these few crystals here, I'll start back up at the tip. is where things get a little complicated. These pieces of the stair are so tiny. We are about halfway done, which is awesome. So this is probably gonna take a little more than one more hour, but that's okay. Might take an hour and a half to finish this up. Unless I somehow start moving quicker than I have been. is starting to cramp. Probably need to loosen my grip on my pen. dogs are hearing something. Couldn't tell you what, though. Baby boy, did you scare away whatever it was? Are you standing on my scrap paper right now? Oh, there you go. Wondered what that pounding was. I mean, it's It's a nice day to work, that's for sure. Oh, sweet pea, stop itching. You're only gonna make it worse. Dry skin is a struggle right now in this house. Hi, Elizabeth. Those of you guys sticking with me right now, I have to give you props. For watching me trace for an hour and a half. Thank you, Elizabeth. I like the quality that the white outline is giving the crystals right now. I think I'm gonna do him real quick and then I'll continue up. Oh, I love that, Kiki. Yeah, especially if you've got a project that you're doing right next to me as you have this on. Oh, that's awesome. What kind of project or page or whatever you're working on? What is it? How far are you? Are you liking it so far? Though I know sometimes that's a loaded question. Because I know when I'm smack dab in the middle of a project, I usually don't like it very much. Because it's sort of in that ugly stage where you're like, okay, how is this going to come together? That sounds amazing, Kiki. I'm terrified of cold foil. I don't know why. I just am. But I love mixed media pieces. Yeah, that's usually how I start out. It's like, well, I don't dislike it. I feel like it could be going someplace good right now. Because I have to tell you, when I first started this page and I was testing things out and I just went for it and traced out that one crystal, I'm like, did I make a mistake choosing to outline the crystals? Because now I have to do all of the crystals. Okay, so the gold foil is already in the coloring book. You're just kind of working around it. That sounds interesting. Are you working on February's TBR, Elizabeth? But January's not even over yet. You have 5 days. No, I understand. I do know that one of the next videos I want to get up is February releases. Go you, Kiki. Go you. It's always terrifying when you're trying something new for the first time. Especially when it's media that you can't necessarily take back. There's no undo. Okay, so you're preempting what books you want to read to play those reading games. That's always fun. I do know there's a couple books that I need to read for NetGalley. And there's a couple book club books that I need to read. But other than that, I never really plan out too much. That's why I never do a TBR video. Because half the time I'm like, let's read this one. This one sounds good. Well, that's impressive, Kiki. Should probably do this guy before I get too far over. Maybe this won't take me. How did the first half of the picture? Oh, it might have been because my Posca pen was being a teenager. But I think I will get this finished in the 2 hours I gave myself. Those dogs. Sometimes I just don't know what to do with them. As you can tell, their life is really hard. So, if you don't mind me asking, Elizabeth, how many do you have to pull from NetGalley right now? Like, how many books have you been approved to read that you haven't read yet or reviewed? Because technically, right now, I only have three still remaining on my to read list on NetGalley. I know with time and experience, managing those arcs and those reviews and being approved will just kind of happen. But I'm just curious how many books you have available to you on NetGalley right now. Like I said, if you don't want to tell me, I totally understand too. is super impressive, Elizabeth. Okay. So I have a little something to work towards. I am sometimes in awe. Of how some of you guys can read. I used to think I was a power reader, and then I joined the online reading community, and I realized that there are people who are even more power readers than I am. So I still have something to aspire to. That is just crazy. Okay, so there's one thing that I vastly dislike about all of the Kirby books so far, and that's the hidden object part. Of his coloring books. I mean, that might have been a nice gimmick at the very beginning, but it is definitely not the reason that I buy his coloring books. I find them a bit obnoxious, if I'm honest. I mean, I end up working around them, but they just seem so silly. Okay, so you don't even request them. They just kind of show up in your, "Hey, can you please review this?" section. I will say one thing that did drive me nuts was I got approved to read a book the same day that the book was archived. So I couldn't even read the book. So I'm like, what is the point of approving me for this read if I now can't get to this read? It all seemed a little bit silly. Well, I guess it doesn't matter because my hand is going to be right here anyways. So technically, I think it's okay if I work from the bottom up. it is, but I almost like tracing from the bottom up the best. Yeah, NetGalley is a pretty fun place to get yourself lost in. Get a little bit of a preview of what's coming out. And let's be honest, it's sometimes hard to say no to free books. And what I didn't realize when I made the goal to start using NetGalley is the fact that I already had a NetGalley account that I had started 5 years ago. So on my NetGalley profile, it looks like I've been on NetGalley for 5 years. I really haven't been using it for 5 years. Sounds like somebody's scraping some ice. So, if you're into ASMR, I don't know if my microphone's even picking up the sound, but I can definitely hear it. I'm really looking forward to when I have my office space downstairs finished. Mean, not that I don't mind where I'm at currently. It's just the street sounds that and the fact that people can just see me from the front street right now, sitting here talking to myself. I'm just an awkward human being. Move my mouse, my arm is gonna start hitting it. Is one good thing about having a Yeti microphone is the fact that it's directional. So since it's behind the microphone, it doesn't necessarily pick up the sound as much. but I honestly don't know how loud the sound is. So it's good to know that the microphone isn't necessarily picking it up right now. It's a little psychedelic. It's kind of extra and it's kind of fun. I don't think this is something I ever would have done before. But I love how live streaming with you guys pushes me to do a little bit more than I would normally do. Oops. Was a little heavy-handed. You know, I probably would. I mean, if it's something that I was doing for myself, maybe not. I don't know. That might be a lie because there are some pieces that I have been a little extra on. But this was, I don't know if I would have tried this outline technique if I had been doing it by myself. Because I know, hold on, let me see if I still have it. Is it in Anamorphia? Lost track where, okay, yeah. So in Imagimorphia, I did this, and that wasn't necessarily on stream, and oh, this took me forever because I wanted like depth and shading, and this is one of the pictures. This was before I was live streaming, and so this is one of the pictures where I really started going more for those realistic coloring techniques. And I don't think I would have ever started going this direction if I hadn't fallen into the coloring community and started seeing all the other techniques that everybody else was using. Because I know before I even started in on the coloring community, I was going more of the flatter techniques, which there's nothing wrong with that. It's just a different kind of style. Now as I watch everybody else and learn all the little things that everybody else does, I wanna try them. Oh, and I waited too long and now I gummed up. I think that's the problem. I start talking. And then the Posca pen just dries up. Noted. Don't start talking until I'm done with the picture. Yeah, it kind of does look like a little bit of ice. I wanted to kind of do something that made it seem more surreal and less flat. I mean, not necessarily just shading wise, but I feel like there's a little more life in it because of the outline. I don't know if that even makes sense. I don't know. I guess you kind of start to do things a little bit differently when you know that there are people watching and sort of judging what you're doing. And that can be good and bad. I know it's pushed me to try things. I mean, it's the whole reason I joined the reading community is because my reading had stagnated and I hadn't picked up a book in so long. And I figured if, hey, I had some accountability by starting making videos about what I was reading and my thoughts on the books. And I think the same thing is true with these live streams. There are times where I feel a little bit of a burnout because of it. There are also times where I'm pushed and inspired to try something that wouldn't have happened otherwise. And look at that. We are almost done. A few pieces here. Are we done? I don't know how I feel about that. I'm gonna go over a few spots over here. It's not quite where I want it to be. forgot a couple lines. My lines are by no means perfect. I'm gonna do a little bit of a bolder outline around where the crystals hit the sky. Told you, sometimes I have a hard time just stopping. Because I just keep going and going. I see little things and I'm like, oh, but what if I do this? Do the same for the crystal that the wizard is flying on. Dun, 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 dun. I feel like I should be playing music right now. I don't know if this is even making a difference that you guys can see, but I do know it is smoothing out some of the disjointed lines on my end. Because of how I was working through the sections. And I know I'm not gonna get a true, I wanna make that more of a point, a true opaque white. I have yet to find a white like that that I enjoy using. I know know you can get some truly opaque whites in paint form. Okay, I think I started doing that around here, and I need to go. This way. Clean things up. But I don't feel like I have a lot of control with a paintbrush. I'm still not confident in my painting skills. Suppose that is something I can work on. But my line work with a paintbrush, non-existent. I don't know how people can even do straight lines. I'm gonna just do him real quick. Then I am going to call it. And just put that right there. Okay, we're done. Oh, and it only took us the 2 hours that I said it was gonna take us. That is magical. Oh my gosh. Thank you guys for hanging out and talking with me as I finished up this page. This has been an epic journey in the making. I'm going to do a speed color version of this. I'm going to put all of the clips together so that if you want to watch the full journey of it all at once, but that's probably going to take me a while to put together and edit. So that's probably not going to be up for a couple of weeks, but I am going to do that in case you guys are interested. But thank you guys so much for hanging out with me today. I will be back next week, probably just on Sunday at 11. I'm probably not going to do both days. Maybe there might be some other events going on that weekend, but that's beside the point. However, at 5 o'clock today, 5 Central, I will be over at Shay's channel at Shay Geeks Out to do our book club discussion about A Heart So Something and Lonely, Fierce and Lonely, Fierce and Broken. It's the second book in the It's by Bridget Creamer. I don't even remember. Like I said, I get the titles, long titles in me do not get along, especially when they're all this and this and this, which has been a theme recently in the book titling, which I don't know if I'm a fan of or not. But anyways, I will be over on her channel at 5 Central today. If you guys want to come and hang out with us, I will of course tweet the link out when that happens. But otherwise, I hope you guys have a wonderful Sunday, and I heart your beautiful faces. Bye.